class representative. Right here in the setting that's very important. We're in South Beach right now. You see what that sign says? It says support the troops, bring them home now. I'm looking at tombstones. It took me like 20 tombstones to get somebody in their 30s, B. I'm talking about kids that are 19, kids that are 25 years old. They out. Out for what though? That's what you gotta ask yourself. You see, one thing that really pisses me off about my people, because I'm a Latino, Puerto Rock, but I'm American. I was born in the States. So I'm gonna talk about Americans. And when homeboy Mr. President Bush was talking about weapons of mass destruction, I think my people wasn't really paying attention to what he was saying. You know what I'm saying? I mean, check the word out. Say it to yourself like 5 times. Weapons of mass destruction. We're talking nuclear. We're talking weapons that could destroy half a nation. And they didn't have nothing. And all these kids right now are dead. You know what I'm saying? Why didn't you ask yourself questions? Why didn't you ask them questions at that time? Everybody jumped on the bandwagon. Everybody was like, oh, rowdy, rowdy, patriotic. I'm a patriotic dude. I love my country. And that's why I rep the other side. I rep the troop side, the 9/11 troop side, the Iraq war troop side. You know what I'm saying? And that's one thing I think people need to start really doing. I'm not going to get into the whole aspect of how we got in the war and Rumsfeld and Condoleezza and all that. All I'm going to say, if anybody's out there listening, you can hate on me or you could be like, nah, it's real. Just, yo, ask questions, B. I mean, if somebody comes up and says, yo, your daughter's a prostitute, you're not going to just believe it. You know, if somebody comes up to you and tells you, yo, your mom's is robbing from stores, you know, she got old and now she's just stealing from all the TJ Maxx's. Are you just going to believe it or are you going to go and find out, investigate? We're talking about sending millions, sending hundreds of thousands of kids out to war and nobody asked questions, homie. And now we see what's happening. You know what I'm saying? Years later, we see what's happening and it ain't going to stop. It ain't gonna stop, that's for sure. I'm over here kind of grinning. I'm grinning because it makes me laugh that people could be like that, but it's a serious situation. Wars should be the last resort. There should always be like 10 options before, 15 options before you go to war, homie. And this was like the first or the second. It was the first option, you know, and then they let UN come in for like a couple seconds, and then they're like, let's go to war. And that's not the way it works. That's not the way it works in a democratic country, you know what I'm saying? I mean, we might as well be in a dictatorship. If you ask yourself, this country's been run by two families in the last 20 years. That's the Bush and the Clintons. To me, that's dictatorship. But y'all voting, right? And your votes count, right? So if your votes count, then make your voice count. And check this right here, you know what I'm saying? 28, 21, 25, 19, you know what I'm saying? Think of it as if it was your kids, your family, you know what I'm saying? It's not like I'm anti-government, United States. I'm all pro my government and all pro my country. You just gotta be smart, put the right people on there, and remember one thing. You don't work for the government. The government needs you. The government without you is nada. It's nothing. You understand? Without your voice, without your dough, without your taxes, without you working. You understand? So if you're gonna work for something and you're gonna live somewhere, make it work, man. Make it work, man.